Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome. My name is John Pyatt. I'm the Director of Federal Relations for the University of Illinois System and President of the 2014 Science Coalition. Welcome to today's briefing, which is sponsored by the House Science and National Labs Caucus. We've got our two co-chairs here with us today. For those of you who don't know, the Science Coalition is a nonprofit, nonpartisan organization of the nation's leading public and private research universities. We work to raise awareness about the value of the federal government's investment in basic scientific research through things like our Sparking Economic Growth Report, which I hope everyone picked up on the way in, and today's briefing. We also honor members of Congress whose actions and votes consistently reflect the belief that basic scientific research conducted at universities and national labs all across this country is essential to our nation's ability to address pressing issues in health, national security, energy, and beyond. We recognize members who get it, that strong, federally supported research enterprise drives innovation in our economy. So we are very pleased to be able to steal a few minutes at the start of today's briefing to recognize a co-chair of this caucus, Congressman Shaka Fatah of Pennsylvania, with the Science Coalition's Champion of Science Award. And we are doubly pleased because Congressman Hultgren from Illinois, a past award recipient himself, is here to present it. So let me turn it over to you, Congressman.
Thank you so much. Well, thank you so much all for being here, John. Thank you to the Science Coalition. Thank you so much. This is really such an exciting process for us, and one more important step. But and just I'm excited to have you here, very excited about the caucus, the National Science and Laboratories Caucus. And the idea, as John mentioned, behind the caucus is really to educate members of Congress of the importance of the science ecosystem, of how our research universities, how our laboratories, how industry all work together, and how without one functioning well, all suffer. And that is so important for us. And I am so pleased that you're here today, so pleased with the great work that the Science Coalition is doing. And once again, to make this recognition of if we aren't doing this research, we suffer as a nation. We become less of an innovative nation. And we don't have great innovation, great discovery, and great new business startups. And it's one of the things I'm excited about with discussion today with the Science Coalition Sparking Economic Growth 2.0. Talks about 100 new companies, or 100 more companies that have started up or doing things because of national research and our commitment of our laboratories and our research universities. So this is a great topic, a great subject, and I'm so especially pleased today and honored to be able to recognize a good friend of mine and my co-chairman, someone who has absolutely been a visionary in this idea of making sure all members of Congress understand the importance of our laboratories, of our research universities, and how this all works together, and the really strong importance of basic scientific research. Congressman Fatah and I talked, a couple years ago about this idea of starting up this caucus, recognizing that many of us who have national labs in our district are passionate about our laboratory, but don't always understand how the laboratories work together and the value of all of our laboratories and how each one plays a specific part. So I can understand how certain members who have a lab in their district are passionate about their lab. What I love about Congressman Fatah, my co-chairman, is he's done something I think no other member of Congress has done, and that is he has visited and toured almost every national laboratory in our country, but he doesn't have a national laboratory in his district. That is so impressive to me of his passion and his commitment and his realization of how important this is and how you need to get on the ground to see how this works and meet the people and see the scientists and the researchers, the engineers, the physicists, the work that they're doing. And so I appreciate that. He also has been such a champion for brain science research and initiative there with the neuroscience, and that's inspiring to me and going to be groundbreaking, I know, with the new discoveries we're going to see that are going to change lives as far as people who and families who are suffering from Alzheimer's and all of the other brain disorders that we see. And so much can happen there if we see that next great breakthrough. I know there's so many initiatives that you've been involved in, but I think more than anything else that I appreciate about you is your persistence, that you get on something and you don't let go of it. And that is how you get something done here in Congress, is you catch a vision, you get the understanding you need, and then you work to get it done. And that is something I've never met anybody who does that better than you, bringing people together, people from different thoughts, different backgrounds, different parties, recognizing that that's the only way we're going to get something good done. So I congratulate you. There is no one more deserving of the Champion of Science Award for this year than you. So please join me in welcoming and congratulating Congressman Fattah, the Champion of Science.
Thank you. Congratulations. You're going to sell you.
Let's stand over here.
Sounds good.
Well, thank you.
I'll hold it for you.
Let me thank my chairman. He calls me a co-chair, but he's really the lead in this effort around national labs and science, and he's done such an extraordinary job. I visited two labs near and dear, the Fermi and the Aragon labs, and but it is true that I've been around, but I've also know that you came here to hear the panelists. So I'm not going to give you a long dissertation. I want to thank my hometown university, University of Pennsylvania, and I know you're going to hear from Dr. Swartzley and Bill for your great leadership and work. I want to thank the Science Coalition for this acknowledgement. And, you know, it seems as though we're in a sequence here. Last night I got the Whitehead Award for my neuroscience initiative, and next week I'm sharing an award with the Prime Minister of Australia. I'm not going down under, however. But this is most important because this is not just because of our work on neuroscience. This is for a more broader array of activities looking at the science enterprise and apparatus in our nation and promoting the notion that if we are going to retain our global leadership position, we can't do that on the cheap. We have to make the investments. We have to be committed to big science, and we have to be committed to basic scientific research. So I am truly appreciative of this acknowledgement, and we're going to keep doing the work that we're doing. I'll close with this, that Eric Cantel, I was with, he's a Nobel laureate in neuroscience, and he said, you know, the key to success is pretty simple at the end of the day, and that is that you keep working. So you heard my chairman say, be persistent. I'm persistent, and as a nation, we need to persist in our success at leading globally in science, and the way to do that is to continue to work hard. Thank you very much.